So welcome back with again with the war. First world war we were doing, I think so. So let's. So for every war, beside everything, there are effects. So what were the immediate effects? Destruction of man and material. You know, wars are doing the same thing. Yeah, explosion of bomb and this and many, many things. Does the same thing. What happened over there? Approximately 6.5 crore people. You can imagine 6.5 crore, 6 crore 50 lakh took part in the war. At least 1 crore died, about 2 crore were injured, and around 70 lakhs were rendered permanently handicapped. You can see the cause, how it affects, war affects over there. More number of people died because of starvation and other form killings and epidemics that broke on after the war. The total war expenditure was quite high. Great problem. Some of dead due to starvation were not having food. If war is there, there will be no work, there will be no work, no money, no money, no food. How much you can survive? So lakhs and lakhs of people dead, crores we can say they dead. Some became permanently handicapped due to this thing. This is wars are the crucial things, as you have seen. Now, what social change came in during the war? Since majority of the men of all nations were on the Mumford woman's shoulder, their responsibility of the family and occupation, they stepped out of their homes and successfully took over the responsibility in the different profession fields. The self-confidence of their being equivalent to the man, and hence consequently demand for women to exercise their franchise was raised. During the war, the production of the things of basic necessity had reduced. So problems like scarcity, unemployment, starvation, strikes, lockouts, etc. raised its head. People suffered a lot, and children conditions were pathetic. The word pathetic, yeah, pathetic, we can say children condition was bad. Where to go? Women came out of their house, they started working because men were busy in the war. No doubt, when revolution came, one change came, women came to know that they are equal to men. For this, what happened? The production became more and more, and in other case, nobody was going to take. Production was in a lot, lots and lots field, we can say. More and more production they got because women were working. And even now, after war, even people, they say they need women in their field because they work very hard, they work very seriously, they do good job. So the role of women was changed now. They came out of there, they became equivalent. So after that, what happened? Scarcity, lack of food, these all things were faced by the people of the world. Because no doubt there was lots of production, but there was no money to buy. What to do? Lack of food, lack of energy, lack of medicines, many, many things. And the position of children, here the word is that pathetic. Means crucial condition was there. Because due to war, they might have lost their parents, their homes. What will be the condition? You can just imagine. Now, the Treaty of Versailles, June 1990. One treaty, one karar, we can say, was done. At the end of the First World War, the unconditional surrender of the German in front of the Allied nation brought an end to the war. Then the Allied nation undertook the peace process in Paris, in which some 58 commissions were formed and 145 sessions were organized. The arrangement we made with the Germany during the Paris peace process was made in the Mirror Palace at Versailles. Thus it came to be known as Versailles Treaty. So now all the representatives of different countries, they got together to make a treaty over there. For what? And it was considered in a famous place, in a palace called Versailles. And so it is named as Versailles Treaty. There were four provisions of the Treaty of Versailles. Number one, regional arrangement, reduction in troop and disassessment, the arrangement of the distribution of the gains at the end of the World War, and war fine. Other provisions, the American President Woodrow Wilson, British Prime Minister Lord George, French President Salamanca, and Italian President Orlando played an important role in the treaty. Germany was found responsible for the war. A war fine of about 6.5 billion, B-I-L-L-I-O-N, not million, pound was imposed on Germany. It had to give away the Ruhr region to France. Its Rhine River had to be opened for international sea route. The Rhineland region on French border was dissolved from being a fortress as being as the mineral rich region was given away to France for 15 years. Most of the German organizations were confiscated. Alsace and Lorraine were to be returned to France. Besides this, Germany was given to France and other allied nations a large quantity of coal and iron annually as a benefit of the war. Germany was made to sign these terms and conditions on gunpoint, and forcibly, because of which there was bitterness and disapprobation amongst Germans. Consequently, the German economy failed miserably. So all the factors came to Germany. The president of America, the president of France, president of England, they all became equal and forced Germany to give 6.5 billion pound as they had started the war. They have to give particular region to France. They have to give coal, iron and many things. And due to this, Germany was totally collapsed. And you know, a person when he is collapsed, he or she becomes jealous. And this jealousy becomes anger. And anger seems, what happened? Again, war. There is nothing else than that. Now, long-term effects. There was a feeling of revenge in signing the treaty with the nations that were defeated in the war. Peace could not be established with the treaty. Socialistic Russia was not given a place in the League of Nations. America did not join the League of Nations. That's why it can be said that the reason for the Second World War was in peace process of the First World War itself. Then what happened? Russia was not given proper position. America was not given proper position. Only the European countries became the veto power, we can say. And this created the seeds of Second World War. Now there is one other main point. The Russian Bolshevik Revolution in 1978, certain time, at that time in Russia. What happened? This is one of the important point that is asked every year. You will get short note, yeah, long answer regarding this thing. The Russian Revolution 1970 considered as an important event in the world history. The Russian had been oppressed and suppressed by the Tsar, because Tsar of Russia, the Russian Tsars, Yazans, we can see, who inherited in the position, were all dictators and enjoyed uncontrolled rule over people. So as monarchy was going on, we can say, yeah, we can say dictatorship, a person ruling over the country, and wherever in the world, the person who rules over the country, he became the supremacy. As we can see the position of North or South Korea, something Jinping, yeah, something is that. He is ruling over there. There are about 200 only in the whole country. There are only 200 net connections. Nobody can use net. You all are lucky. You are all Indians. Or we all are lucky, we can say. We are Indian. We are free for everything. But once we are under the dictatorship or a monarchy, so it happens in Russia also. People did not have any rights during the period. The Tsars went so cruel and pitiless on people that if anybody demand for any rights, he has tortured, suppressed and severely punished or come back to Saint Petersburg, born chilling and dead cold of Siberia. The uncontrolled and oppressive Tsardom became the reason for greed, poverty and suffering among people. The Russian farmers, laborers and peasants were not getting enough income. Despite working very hard, they become very poor. So the condition of the people were too much crucial. The farmers, the peasants, the workers, they were in too much trouble. They worked too hard, but they didn't get, because the Tsarism, because the Tsars, they ruled over there, they used to punish them. There not a single right was maintained over there. So it was a condition of wrapping up, we can say. Then what happens? Under the leadership of the father Gopam, a large rally was taken out to the Tsar's residence, Winter Place, Palace, 22nd January 1905, Sunday. These people were unarmed, and some had the Tsar's picture in hand with captions like "Long live the little white lord of Russia" written on it. The Tsar's army opened fire on these innocent people, because of which thousands of innocent people died, and the snow in Pittsburgh, where the Tsar palace was situated, turned red blood with red blood. This day is known as Bloody Sunday in history. So some for protest, some people went in front of the Tsar's palace. They didn't demand, but they got bored within their hand to save their country, and the Tsars told the military to fire on them. They fired, and the whole white area, because of snow and ice, was covered in with the bloody shed. And it is called Bloody Sunday in history. Around time, a large number of Russians got provoked and became restless, as the weakness of the Tsarism had become obvious. With a small nation like Japan had defeated a massive nation like Russia in the Russia-Japan War in 1904 and 5. In order to pacify the angry Russians, an announcement to call for Duma Legislative Assembly, which had been called for years, was made. Eventually, for such Duma were called, but before it can take steps to satisfy the citizen, it had been called out. And at that time, Japan attacked Russia. Japan won the war, and that became a shameful thing for the people, and people revolted. But Legislative Assembly, one great meeting was going to be held for this thing, but it all collapsed. Then what happened? On 8 March 1970, the oppressed workers of Petrograd called for a strike. The Tsar sent this troop to contain this event, but the army refused to shoot these people. As a result, the rebellion began. After the fall of the Tsarism, the power fell in the hands of rascally Menshevik group minority. Except for Lenin, everyone in Russia was happy with the fall of the Tsar, but Lenin believed in the importance of laborers as propagated by Karl Marx, while the Menshevik group believed in the importance of middle class. As a result, Lenin instigated the Bolsheviks against Mensheviks in November 1917, declared the final revolution, got the reins in his hand. This became to known as Socialistic Bolshevik Revolution. Thus, the 300 years old Tsarism came to an end, and for the first time, Russia was without a Tsar. Then what happened? You can see that revolutions take place when people are fed up. So a leader came in front of, and then a huge protest against them. The Tsars told the militant to fire on them, but military was away with them. Another one mean Lebanon, another person who came as a leader, he told that you have to think of the laborer, not of the middle class. Again there was a revolution, and at last he came forward, and he won, we can say, people won their rights, and it is called the Russian Revolution. Now the League of Nations, what are the League of Nations? The horrors of the world war explained the absolute necessity of the world peace to the nation of the world, and for this, a need for an international organization was felt. So it became necessary to think actively and immediately about the world peace. The American President Woodrow Wilson and his contemporary would assemble substantially in the establishment of the League of Nations. The 14 points suggested by the Woodrow Wilson were pretended during the Paris peace process on 10th January 1920. The League of Nations was formed. Now they all thought that this war has created many disastrous possibilities over there. Now what to do? to stop the war, to live in peace. Peace is the main thing to live in. What to do? So American president, he made a list of 10 points. What are they? Aims of the League of the Nation. Number one, to maintain international peace and security, every nation to respect the unity and dignity of the nation, to give up the policy of war, to develop international relations, to solve international disputes peacefully through negotiations or meditation. If any nation ignores the League of Nations or it meditations, it would be declared as a rebel nation. This League of Nations established for world peace but did not manage to keep a control over the imperialist policies of the superpower, and in 1939, the Second World War. No doubt, these some 6 points are too much important for everything. But each and every nation doesn't practice it well. And somewhere, sometime, it created problem. And at last, there was a result of the Second World War. I think so, you all might have gone through this lesson. Some words, some sentences are little bit, you can say, not hard yet, tough one. You can go through. Now you are in secondary, you are not in primary. You all are mature one, you all are genius. Read it over. Any doubt, please contact me. Thank you very much. This our lesson 2 is finished. One lesson from civic section we have finished, 2 from history. Now 2 lessons are remaining for your Ekam Kasoti unit test. We will continue with the next lesson. Till that, thank you. Thank you very much.